What's up, you guys? My name is Carson Rouse, and welcome back to Business Buzz, where we focus on business, entrepreneurship, and investing. Today, I'm going to teach you how to become financially independent, wealthy, and retire early using these FIRE movement tips. How nice would it be to just retire early and spend your days doing what you love and what you're passionate about and just chill and know that you are secure and safe in your future? Probably sounds like a dream for most of us, especially for those of you in the rat race like we basically all are. What if I told you though that you could turn this dream into a reality using tips from the FIRE movement? The FIRE movement is a movement that has been heating up very hot lately, and it stands for Financially Independent Retire Early, and it's all about building a great net worth to be able to retire as early as possible and enjoy a fruitful long retirement. Many successful young people are involved in the FIRE movement. Heck, even Graham Stephan, the king of YouTube, at least in my niche, has been involved with the FIRE movement. He said in a few of his videos that for a few years there, he was heavily involved in going onto the forums and talking with other people about the FIRE movement. You see, most people don't actually end up retiring until the age of around 65, give or take. People often find this problematic, considering that you're going to work hard and bust your balls for 45 years, only to be really free for 10 or 20 years, and by then you're all old and decrepit and can't really do much. So that's why I'm going to be talking through the four FIRE movement tips so that you can be a retiree in your 50s, 40s, and heck, maybe even 30s. But before we get into the video, you gotta go down and smack that like button. Let's begin with number one, budgeting. Budgeting is one of the most vital things that you can do if you plan on retiring early. If you don't want to budget your money and monitor it closely, you may as well exit this video right now. Budgeting can really range in severity depending on what your goals are. It can be abstaining from buying that Dunkin' coffee every day, or it can be as severe as living off $400 a month. But what we do know is that over time, if you can manage not to spend your money on stupid things, unnecessary things, you can definitely build your net worth, because instead of putting that money into a stupid little yo-yo, you can put that money into an investment account. I'm actually going to go through a little example here. Let's say every day from the time you're 18 to the time you're 60, you buy a $5 coffee from Starbucks every day. But instead, let's say that instead of putting that money into coffee, you invest that money into the S&P 500. That'll go to about $150 a month in an investment account that's going to get you around 9.8% a year. At that rate of return, by the time you're 60 years old, you would have built an investment account worth $913,000. I don't know about you guys, but that sounds a whole lot better than wasting $75,000 on coffee throughout your life. If this little example teaches you anything, it should be that a little bit of budgeting can build you massive wealth in the long term. And when you start budgeting on the little things, it starts to expand into the bigger things, and then you just become a little obsessed with it. It's really crazy to think that just an extra $5 a day on coffee could end up being another $1 million in addition to your net worth. So instead, you can use Graham Stephan's 20-cent iced coffee, or just make it at home and make it way cheaper. Number two. Figure out how much you need for retirement. Many people blindly go into their retirement without actually ever figuring out what they're going to need to last and have a good retirement. Most people go their whole life contributing to their retirement without ever knowing if they're going to have enough. They just put it in and hope that they see big numbers by the time they retire. That's why you should always have a goal in mind, according to your age as well. Always have a number that you need to hit by the time you're a certain age. So if you need to retire by the time you're 60, or you want to, obviously you're going to need less money saved than if you want to retire by the time you're 40. This will not only give you some peace of mind knowing that you have a goal set in mind and that you will be safe once you reach that goal, but it also allows you to adjust your savings to know exactly what you'll need to save to reach that goal by a certain date. A good tool to use here is the Vanguard Retirement Income Calculator. You enter in all your information, your age, your current wealth situation, and it will calculate all of this for you. I'm going to leave a link for that in the description. It's definitely going to help you guys out, so make sure to check it out. It just gives you an idea of what you're going to need to hunker down and do. And remember to also keep in mind Social Security when you pay taxes to Uncle Sam over the course of your life. You gotta realize that you're gonna be getting money from the government back in Social Security. As long as you retire after the age of 62 or you are legally disabled, you will get Social Security, so you gotta keep that in mind as part of your retirement income. It's like the default retirement income. Number three, affordable housing. A big mistake that a lot of people make is they pay for housing that they really don't need and is way beyond their wealth situation that they really can't afford, but they buy it anyway. An example of this would be renting an apartment in downtown New York City and paying $3,000 to $4,000 a month when you could just live way outside of the city and take a subway into work every day and save thousands on your rent. Again, so much of your retirement comes down to your frugality and savings, and because your mortgage or rent or whatever to do with housing is such a big bill in your life, this is possibly the most important thing when it comes to budgeting and saving money. There's even an entire online forum surrounded on house hacking, and it'll teach you anything to do with saving money with your house, whether it be saving money on rent or getting more bang out of your buck with electricity or plumbing or whatever it may be. House hacking can honestly save you a tons of money throughout the years if you play your cards right. Number four, retiring abroad. I know many of you will not even consider this because you have family in the US and they won't relocate, but if you just don't like your family or you know you're fine with leaving them, this could be a great way to save money for your retirement. Many foreign countries are very cheap to live in. You know, their living situations, you could be living high off the hog there for a tenth of the price that you'd be paying in the US. They're great retirement destinations, and honestly, some of these countries are absolutely beautiful to live in. Obviously, because you'd need way less money to retire in these spots, you could retire much earlier because you'd need less years to build up more wealth. Countries like Costa Rica, Portugal, Panama are all beautiful countries that you can live in for, again, half the cost that you'd be living in the US. In fact, I know a guy who moved to Costa Rica and bought this beautiful home that in the US would have cost him millions and millions of dollars, but in Costa Rica, definitely didn't. And I will say, many of these, you know, affordable countries, they do tend to be more dangerous in the US, but it's all about the areas that you're living in. And if you live in a good area, you should be just fine. You may be paying a bit more, but I think it's worth it. For example, in Panama, you can go to a really nice restaurant and eat like a king for like $4, and paying a few hundred dollars a month for your living expenses, you can just live like a king there. While doing this, you can even keep your money invested and just live off of your interest and dividends. That's like the American dream, just living off dividends. Again, this is a unique idea. I know this won't apply to many of you, but that's all about the FIRE movement. I mean, it's all unique. It's something that most people aren't comfortable with doing, but it's whether you're comfortable with doing it. And again, this isn't just for retirement. Even if you live in a foreign country for just a few years and just bank your money for that time, you could save a ton of money by the time you retire. In fact, we made a whole video on how to be a digital nomad and all about their lifestyle. They basically make a US wage living in other countries. They all do all their work online. It's a pretty great lifestyle. If you want to learn about that, check out this video right here. But anyway, I really hope you took something of value. If you took something of value, please make sure to like this video. I want at least 15 likes on this video. I want 15 likes. Also, go down and subscribe.